Hey everyone, this is Nick. I just tried to do a YouTube live where I made this chart from scratch, and it was the most weird, difficult thing to do, and the most boring thing that I have probably ever watched when I watched it back. So I gotta figure out how to make these live sessions a little bit more lively and engaging, but probably until I do that, I wanted to put out a quicker video on how to make this diverging stacked column chart in PowerPoint. So I had a friend who messaged me a while ago, and she asked me, she's like, Nick, how did you make this chart? Are those just individual stacked bar charts and then you just sort of nudge them into place on the slides wherever they need to do? No, don't ever do that. I hope nobody does that. This is one single chart and we can make it really easy with just a few little behind the scenes workarounds. So we're gonna make this from scratch into right from a PowerPoint slide. You don't have to make the chart in Excel and then paste it over into PowerPoint or into Word and format it over there. You can do it right inside of PowerPoint. You just need the source data that you've already analyzed so that we can paste that into the data source in our slide. So I'm going to show you what I mean by this. So this is a new slide right here. You'll probably have a placeholder like this, a content placeholder. If you do, you can go ahead and click on this little chart button and insert a chart. Otherwise, you're going to go to the insert tab on the menu and then go to your chart menu here, and then that's where you'll insert a chart from. But I'm going to go ahead and stick with this placeholder, and we're going to go ahead and insert a chart. I'm going to click that box, go to the column charts here, right there on the chart sort of picker. And then over here, we have an option for a stacked column and a 100% stacked column. I'm gonna go with the 100% stacked column. So let's do that and then click on it and then say, okay. And the great thing about PowerPoint is that it pops up with this chart with some dummy data for us. This is a great way to understand how chart data is laid out behind the scenes. You can see that in PowerPoint there. Excel doesn't give that to us yet. I think Excel will give it to us in the future. But let's see what happens here with these data. So you can see the data is laid out like this. I have my data analyzed already, my overall experience rating by year. So this is the less than excellent, excellent, and outstanding, the three categories that we have sort of aggregated into our original overall experience rating. I'm gonna go ahead and just copy this. I'm gonna do Control C to copy. And we'll go back to my slide here with the data source window popped up, Control V to paste. And now you can see everything just kind of goes into place there. It's a little bit wonky right now, but let me do a few things. So bear with me here. We're gonna delete category 4. We don't need that. That's row 5, so delete that. And then you can kind of see that this chart isn't formatted, or it's not oriented in the way that we would normally want to do it. So you can see the less than excellent, excellent, outstanding categories are along the axis instead of the years. So in order to switch those things, let's go up to the data menu right here and then say switch row and column. When we do that, that's going to switch the rows and columns in the chart. And now you can see the chart's starting to look pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and just delete that title, and let's go ahead and just adjust the legend so that it's off to the right and the sideways, because I want you to still see what happens here when we work with some of these chart settings. So I'm going to keep that data source window open like this. Now I'm going to add a row. In order to make that diverging stacked treatment, we need to add two rows to this chart. And these are going to be the helper rows, or kind of the buffer rows. We're going to insert the row right here below our data. And I want the diverging point to be between less than excellent and excellent on my chart. So what we're gonna do for this first row is we're gonna put in a formula. It's gonna be 100% minus whatever data live in this row right here, the less than excellent row. So equals 1 minus, and then point to that cell, push enter, and that gives us the remainder there. And I'm gonna drag that across the row to copy it. It's gonna be perfect. Let's just call this helper 1. Let's go down to outstanding right here, and we're gonna say helper 2. Now this is a little bit different of a formula because I want that cut point to be between less than excellent and excellent. We need to do the 100% minus the sum of whatever is above that cut point here. So in this case, it's excellent and outstanding. So I'm gonna say 1 equals 1 minus sum, open the parentheses, and then point to these two cells, I'm gonna add them together. Close the parentheses and then click enter, and there you have the remainder remainder there. Now I'm going to drag that across to copy, and now you can see how my chart is sort of starting to take shape. This is my helper 2 series right there. I'm going to go ahead and just turn it white or no fill. That's going to be great. And then this is my helper 1 series, and I'm going to turn that no fill as well. Now I can sort of delete these from the legend. Just double click to highlight one of those series, and then you can see that this gives us a nice chart. Now, you could probably just leave this chart sort of kind of as is. Probably not, actually. We want to do a little bit of formatting to this chart to make it look even better. The one thing that I think is interesting is that the first thing I'm going to do is actually just recolor some of the things. So the outstanding category, I want to be this really solid blue right here from my palette. This excellent category, I want to be a lighter shade of blue, and then the less than excellent, I want to be a darker shade. So maybe a gray like this. Now, I would love to have a line that cuts right here. So you could draw a line on your chart if you wanted to, or there's a little bit of a hack, a little bit of a workaround to make sure that your legend axis line right down here moves up to that 50% line. So I'm gonna click on the axis. We're gonna go ahead and format the axis right here. And then under axis value, I'm gonna say 0.5. So put 0.5 in that axis value right there. Sorry about the ambulance that's going by my house right now. We are gonna go ahead and push enter. And now you can see that axis line goes right up to that 50% line. However, so do the labels. So we're gonna make sure to click on labels and then say low. And then that puts the labels down there, but the line, axis line, is still there. I'm gonna go ahead and close out my data source window for the time being. So what we can do now is we can delete our y-axis right there. I'm going to go ahead and click on those labels right there. You can see that it highlights the line above here, that 50% cut line. Let's make that a little bit darker so that we can see it. So solid line, and we'll just make it that nice, that big shade of black. I'm going to maybe make it a little thicker, 1.25. Now you can really see that nice cut point line. Now, I actually got rid of my y-axis a little too soon because I want to fill more of the plot area with this chart. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my axis back. We're going to go to chart elements and go to axis, and I want that vertical axis back. So right there, I'm going to click on the axis, and now let's go ahead and let's do the minimum at 20%. That looks like it might be a good value there. So 0.2. Nice, and now you can see it really fills more of the plot area with the chart. If you're gonna get rid of the axis and you're gonna directly label your chart, you don't need the chart label, and it's okay to maximize the plot area, to maximize the chart area to fill that plot area. It's pretty good. Let's go ahead and get rid of the grid lines too. So I'm just gonna click on those grid lines and delete them. I'm gonna get rid of the legend at this point too, because I'm gonna make my own in just a second. Let's go ahead and fill some of this gap area, this gap width between the bars. So click on any set of bars, go to the bar chart icon. Under gap width, let's set that down to 30, so that fills the plot area a little bit nicer. I'm gonna go ahead and just drag this chart so that it's a little bit over that way, and then we're gonna go ahead and update the axis text. So I'm gonna say black, make it a little bit black, and probably gonna tick this up maybe to 18, that looks pretty good. And then I've already created my own custom legend over here with text boxes. So you just enter a text box and you enter the name, make sure it's color-coded to your chart, and it looks really nice, just like that. Now we want to add the labels, and so I'm going to go ahead and right click each of these series to add the labels, and I'm going to show you a quick little efficiency trick here. Right click and add these labels. Now the first label I'm going to format just like I want. So I'm going to make it white, bold, and then maybe up to, let's see, 16 probably. We could do that way. Now I want the other labels to be just like that too. Instead of going through all those clicks, I'm going to keep this highlighted. I'm going to go to the paintbrush icon right here, the format painter, double click it to make it sticky, and then I'm going to click on the labels, and that's going to format the labels just like I need them perfectly. Copies that formatting from one label to another. Now click the paintbrush icon again to deactivate the format painter. Now let's see, the other thing that I might want to do here, this is my little pet peeve with these diverging charts. So by default, the data label in each of the series goes in the middle or the center of each of those of each of the stacks right here. But for a diverging chart, we have this visual effect of going out towards one of the poles, towards the high end, or down towards the low end. So I want to position the label so that it's going to draw my eye up to those values as well. So in this top value, instead of center, we're going to say inside end, and that's going to go up there. The same thing with excellent. I'm going to say inside end, and then for these labels, I'm going to say inside base because I want them to go lower. So we're going to put them just like that. And there we have a really beautiful diverging stacked column chart. And I think that looks really, really nice. So if you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you. I hope you go and check out that live and you can go ahead and comment, tell me how boring I am, and that would be perfect. Can't wait to see you all next time. Thanks again for watching.